See, now I told you one of the economic problem is what to produce, how much to produce. So we have this production possibility curve, which will help us to understand that problem and solve. So this is also known as production possibility frontier or a transformation curve. So what do we do with PPC? We call it PPC popularly. It shows the various alternative production possibilities which are available to an economy, wherein two goods can be produced with the given resources which we have and the techniques of production which we have. So suppose if I have a tractor and a land, I would come to know using the PPC what alternative production possibilities of two goods are available on that piece of land. Okay, now it is considered to be a very important tool to solve the central economic problems which we discussed earlier. Okay, now it considers an economy which can produce wheat or pulses by using its resources. So basically it will tell you that what can be produced in what quantity, whether wheat can be produced or whether pulses can be produced. To understand this, let's take this example. So we have different production possibilities given. So based on that we can understand, let's say this is in kgs. So if 0 kgs of wheat is produced, we can go ahead and produce 15 kgs of pulses. Okay, wherein if I am using alternative E, wherein I produce 4 kgs of wheat, okay, or let's say 4 tons of wheat, then I can produce 11 tons of pulses. So that's what the PPC is all about. It tells you under different production possibilities based on the techniques you have, what two things you can produce in what quantity. Okay, so production possibility curve will tell you the collection of all the possible combinations which were there, as we saw in the slide, different combinations which were there of goods and services that can be produced from a given amount of resources. Okay, so it tells you, as I showed you here, how much wheat can be produced. Again, if I'm producing this much wheat, how much pulses I can produce. Okay, so this is based on a given stock of technological knowledge which is there, and it is called as the production possibility set of the economy. Okay, so this PPC, that is the production possibility curve, will tell us the maximum amount of wheat that can be produced in an economy for a given amount of pulses and vice versa. So we have this curve as it is being shown to you, and this is the production possibility curve or production possibility frontier. Okay, so you can see the different alternatives being placed. For example, A is coming out here because wheat was 0. Okay, so we have these different possibilities. Now, what are the assumptions for PPC? See, the resources available are fixed, so they assume we have limited resources. They assume the technology will not change, so the technology will remain unchanged. Resources are fully employed and resources are not equally efficient in production of all goods. Okay, now when it comes to properties, remember the PPC would be a downward sloping curve. Okay, it would be a downward sloping curve from left to right due to the inverse relation. Why? We saw that if I'm producing 0 kgs of wheat, I was able to produce maximum pulses. So because of that inverse relation, it would be a downward sloping curve. Now, the shape is always concave to the origin. This is so because the marginal cost of opportunity would increase as things move further. Okay, so because the marginal cost of opportunity tends to rise, so the shape of PPC is concave. As we do more and discuss more in further slides, we'll understand what marginal cost of opportunity is all about.